Hey guys, JPST here, back with another video. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you all of the different ways in which you can get emeralds easily, and by using this method, you can literally get unlimited kind of emeralds. Also guys, in this video, I will be mentioning some tutorials of videos that I made on my channel. All of the links are in the description, or you can always find it in a playlist called Minecraft in my channels. So here you would see a bunch of these chests. My god, what is this horse even doing? Can you please? Okay. Here you can see some chests over here, and each and every chest contains all of the methods to get emeralds in an easy way. So we're going to be jumping on each and every chest one by one, and I'll be showing you all of the different ways over here. And we're going to be using all of the things in the chest to convert them into emeralds, and we're going to be depositing in this. So guys, before I start, the main thing that you need is a villager. So you will definitely need a lot of villagers to actually trade, get unlimited number of emeralds. Now here you can see this is my villager chamber area, and over here you would see I just have a lot of these villagers working for me. Most of them are librarians for the enchantment books, and obviously there are a few other villagers as well. There's almost 20 to 30 villagers over here in this whole chamber. If you guys want to know how you can build this chamber, I did a separate tutorial on it. This is a very, very useful chamber, guys. You won't believe how useful this is, because as you can see, this guy has a bookshelf, and if I want to change something else, and if I want a enchantment book, all I need to do is flick this lever once, like this. Once I flick the lever like that, he will change his trade, and I'm getting a lure over here. I could just do this infinite number of times to change his trades, and I can get any enchantment book just like that. Even got mending very, very easily. As you can see, this guy has a mending, and this guy also has a mending. A lot of them over here have mending, and also some amazing enchantments like efficiency 5 and fortune 3. You could just see my pickaxe itself has this best enchantments. Ball has the best enchantment. My shovel and my axe, all of them have efficiency 5, mending, and whatnot, the best enchantments. So if you guys want to know how you can actually get these rare enchantments very easily, you can go ahead and watch the video in which I showed you how you can get mending very easily. You can use the same method over there in that video to get these rare enchantment books. And guess what, guys? With this chamber, I not only get trades, I also get amazing best discounts. The best discounts in Minecraft. So for example, let me go to a villager and let's see what his trades are. 15 paper for one emerald, and not only that, for a respiration 3 or any enchantment book, he just wants one emerald instead of 10 emeralds, as you can see. So this is the maximum discounts that I could get, and not only this guy, every single one of them over here has amazing discounts. So let's say for example I go to this guy. This guy's gonna ask me 6 coal only for an emerald, and guess what, guys? He's gonna give me a diamond sword for one emerald. It's gonna cost me just one emerald for anything they sell for, including a pickaxe and a shovel. As you can see, just one emerald. So if you guys want to know how you can get this amazing discount, this simple chamber over here is what is allowing me to get these amazing discounts. You guys can go ahead and check that video out. I did a separate video on how you can get these amazing discounts. Now all I need to do is just a simple trick, and all of these people will get discount in the same time. So you guys can go ahead and follow that video. So once you've built yourself a village of breed of farm, and you have a chamber already, and you also have some amazing discounts, let's get into the amazing ways and the easiest ways in which you can actually earn emeralds. So here you would see 6 chests over here, and all of these chests contains different methods in which you can get emeralds. Let's get on to the first chest. This first chest is going to contain sugar canes. We're going to be using sugar canes to convert sugar canes to paper, and we're going to be trading paper with the librarians to get emerald. Now you might as well ask, where will I get so many sugar canes from? So do not worry about that. So there is a sugarcane farm, unlimited sugarcane farm, which is actually AFK and automatic. I will escort you guys over there. Now here you can see, why is there a spider over here? Okay, here you can see, this is the— is that a skeleton inside? What's he even doing inside? Kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are you even doing over here? So anyways, this is the automatic sugarcane farm. It's gonna give you unlimited sugarcanes, and all of the sugarcanes will be deposited into this large chest easily. All you have to do is flick this lever, and it's gonna automatically harvest all of the sugarcanes, and it will actually grow rapidly fast. You can actually get a lot of sugarcane in just a few minutes. So this is like very easy to build, and all it requires is just a few dispensers, a redstone torch, some redstone, and a lever, and some sugarcanes, and just like that, you will have unlimited sugar canes just like that. And that's exactly how I have so much sugar canes in a very short period of time. So I did a separate video on this sugar cane farm. You guys can check that out in the top right corner of this video, or it is in the description of this video as well. You just need to flick this lever and you will get a load of sugar canes. What I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be grabbing all of these sugar canes, converting them to paper, and let's see how many emeralds we can actually get. Now the best part here is, because we have some amazing discounts using my discounted chamber over here, and each and every villager is only gonna cost me 15 paper for iPhone 1 Amarillo. That's actually the most best trade ever. So here you can see I've converted all of the sugar canes to paper. I'm going to trade with all of these villagers over here. So guys, overall I'm left with 64 plus 19 emeralds, just like that, very easy to get. And I have just a few sugar canes and some paper left, and we're gonna deposit this number of emeralds over here. Now method number two is rotten flesh. So you might ask, how the heck do I have so much of rotten flesh? So method 2 and this method 3 over here, which is, let's just keep it as method 2.1, is gonna be the golden farm, which is the gold farm over here. A very simple one, definitely looks bigger, but it is the most easiest to build and it's the most efficient one ever, because guess what guys, it's gonna actually give you 40 levels in just 6 minutes. Just 6 minutes of AFK in this gold farm and you can actually get 40 levels just like that. You can even get to level 200 or 300 in a single day if you can using this gold farm. Now what you want to do is this method over here, we're going to be using this rotten flesh and this gold over here to trade with the villagers to get some emeralds. Before I trade with them, I'm going to be showing you how the golden farm works. And yes, there is a separate tutorial on the gold farm as well. Find it at the top right corner of this video right now, or it is in the description. Now this is the gold farm, and what happens is, if I just need to like flick this lever right over here, and as you can see, this giant nether portal over here is gonna keep on flickering like this. And as you can see, these pigments are all spawning over there. All of them are brought to the end, and they will have some fall damage as they fall down, and they will have 1 health left. And just like how the skeleton and the mob farm works, we're just gonna kill them to get some XP. And within a short span of time, a lot of them are gonna be actually spawned over here, and you're gonna have like a lot of rotten flesh, a lot of gold, and a lot of golden swords as well. And obviously, if you guys didn't know, you can put them into the furnace. Actually, when you put the golden sword into the furnace, you will end up getting 1 golden nugget. As you guys saw, it will get deposited over here if you actually use a furnace to melt down a golden sword. So that is a quick tip you guys want to remember when you make this, because you're gonna actually be getting a lot of these swords which you can use to smelt them down to golden nuggets. Now just a few minutes and as you can see, a lot of them have actually spawned. Let's see how much we can actually get. All I have to do is come here and just do this to them, and as you can see, we're actually getting a lot of loot over here just like that. And we're also getting a lot of XP. Just a few minutes in and we actually got a lot of XP just like that. And they will just keep on spawning no matter what. Unlike the mob spawner and the skeleton spawner, this does not matter on how many pigs are actually spawned. It just keeps on spawning. If you literally just stand here AFK for 20 minutes, you will have a bunch of them. You'll have like hundreds to thousands of them over there, which your system might even start lagging. Now as I said before, all I have to do is this. I'm going to be getting gold, I'm going to be getting rotten flesh, and not only those both, you're gonna be getting a lot of XP as well. Make sure to switch this farm off, because if you don't switch it off, frame rate will drop extremely, because these things will keep on spawning and that is not good for the game. There's gonna be a lot of them spawning in just a few minutes, so make sure to switch that off. Show you guys who you need to trade with to get the maximum profit. Now let's quickly grab all of the rotten flesh first and see how much we can actually get. So I just got all of the rotten flesh. Get inside the chamber, and all you want to do is come to the cleric over here. Now here in the cleric, is gonna give you, it's gonna cost you 32 for 1 emerald. You can obviously use the discount chamber that I did, that I mentioned in the beginning of this video, to get amazing discount. This can actually still go down to almost 15 rotten flesh for 1 emerald. You can just have to repeat the discounted chamber process to get more discount. Now I'm gonna be trading with this guy. So guys, what I'm going to do, I'm also going to be grabbing the gold which we got from the golden farm, and I'm going to be trading all of these gold as well. So let's quickly move on to the next method, method number 3. Now this method number 3 also has 2 chests over here. This chest and this chest, both of them are method number 3. Now this chest is going to contain a lot of strings. So obviously you might ask, where did I get so many strings from? And yes, it is the iron farm. Now this iron farm is going to give you a lot of iron. And exactly here we have just tons and tons of iron ingots that I don't even know what to do with. I just have like so many iron ingots over here. I don't even literally know what to do with at all. Now if you guys want to get a lot of these iron and a lot of these string over here, definitely it is the iron farm. And this iron farm is the most efficient iron farm, and it's gonna actually give you tons of iron and tons of flowers and also tons of strings, because there's gonna be a lot of cats that's gonna be spawning and a lot of iron golems. So guys, the iron farm is actually one of the most efficient things that I've built, and it's actually the most useful till date. And you can actually go ahead and build this one. I did a separate video on how you can build the most efficient iron farm for Bedrock and Java as well. So this is the whole iron form, pretty easy to build. You guys can go ahead and watch that video to build this iron form. You're gonna literally get a lot and lot of iron. So here you can see I just need to go inside over here, and in this spot is where the lot of iron golems and a lot of cats will actually come down to, and this hopper with minecart will collect all of the iron and all of the strings and put it down inside over here. Obviously all of this iron and all of the strings I took from here, and you just have a lot of flowers over here, these red flowers that come out of the iron column that you could use to whatever you want. So this is the iron farm that you can simply build, very easy to build actually. So you guys can go ahead and watch that video on how you can build this amazing iron farm. It's gonna give you a lot of iron. So using this iron farm, we're gonna be going ahead and we're gonna be trading both iron ingots and the strings as well. So guys, if you want to trade these iron ingots, it's very easy to trade iron ingots. You can trade it with the armorer over here. As you can see, one iron ingot for one emerald, which means this, all of these are going to be transferred into emeralds for each of the stack having 64 emeralds. You can trade iron ingots with the armorer or with the weaponsmith or even with this toolsmith over here. Every single one of them is going to ask you one iron for one emerald. And for the strings, you will definitely need a fisherman. He's going to ask you 16 strings for one emerald. That's also a really good trade. Now guys, obviously I cannot be trading with the same villager at the same time a lot of trades, because you will get this X mark over here. This is actually a new update from Minecraft in which you cannot be trading at the same time a lot of trades. So you guys can keep that in mind. And obviously you won't be needing a lot of emeralds at the same time. So whenever you want it, you can trade with the villagers. And obviously in this video, I'm not going to be trading all of my iron ingots, all of my gold ingots and all of my resources to emeralds, because I just already have a lot of emeralds, and using all of these tricks I just have unlimited emeralds. So let's quickly move on to the next method. So guys, the last method is pretty simple, and you don't have to build any farm like you did for the iron farm, for the gold farm or the sugarcane farm. This one, all you need is just a pickaxe. And if you have a fortune 3 pickaxe like I do, as you can see, all you need is just a fortune 3 pickaxe, fortune 3 enchantment, put it on a pickaxe. And if you have that, you just need unlimited number of coal. Coal is very easy to get. Stop getting one coal, you'll get a lot of coal as you mine. Now we can actually use all of these coal to trade with the villagers, and we can actually get emeralds as well using that. Now I'm gonna be showing you an example that this fortune 3 actually works. And here you can see I have almost 30 stacks of coal, and I'm gonna be using all of these 30 stacks, and let's see how much we can actually get. Each of these rows over here have 10 stacks, 10 20 30, and we're gonna see how much coal we can actually get if you actually use a fortune 3 pickaxe. And if you actually mine coal, you will actually get more number of coals than you actually do without the fortune 3. So fortune 3 is actually a really useful one. Now let's see how much we can actually get. Now I just took off all of these 30 of this coal, and we just got like 57. That is almost double the coal that we have. And you can actually, okay, we have some more over here. Okay, let's see how much we got. Okay, we got 58 coal just like that, with 30 stacks of coal just like that. So make sure to use a fortune 3 pickaxe, and with the fortune 3 pickaxe you can just get a lot of coal, and you can trade all of these coals to the villagers for emeralds. And this is another method that you could use, and it's pretty easy to, if you wanna trade coals, obviously you can use the same method that you used for the iron. The same number of these villagers will trade coal as well, as you can see. 6 coal for an emerald. You can just keep on trading until you get the X mark, and obviously after a few minutes this X mark will be gone as well, and you could trade with the same villager once again. If you have more than one type of these villagers, you could definitely trade more just like that. Obviously I'm not going to be trading all of my coal and all of my resources to emeralds. As I told you guys before, I already have a lot of emeralds. I'm just going to be depositing the rest of the emeralds over here. So this is so much of emeralds that I already have, and these are all of the main methods that you could use to get unlimited emeralds. But there's also a few other methods that you could use to actually get more emeralds, and I'm going to be discussing them right now. So guys, as I said before, all of the links are in the description, so make sure to go ahead and watch those tutorials and build the sugarcane farm, gold farm and the iron farm. All these three farms are the most useful, and you can use them to get unlimited emeralds and just unlimited resources. Now let's get on to the other methods in which you can get unlimited emeralds. Now guys, the first one is using flint. Now, so a lot of you actually don't know this, if you actually have a fortune 3 on your shovel, and if you actually use this to mine gravel, you will 100% of the time get a flint on a gravel, which means that you're going to be getting unlimited flint just like that. So using that flint, you could actually trade with the villagers to get a lot of emeralds. So that is one tip that you can use. Now the next method is to trade fishes. Now you can obviously trade fishes, and that you could do them to the through these fishermen over here. You can see that they actually ask you like 11 fishes for one emerald, and you might ask where will I go get a lot of fishes. Do not worry about it. So there's also a tutorial on a fish farm. Yes, a fish farm. You might ask, why would I even need a fish farm? If you didn't know, fishing is actually one of the most important things in Minecraft, because if you fish, you can actually end up getting the rarest enchantment books and a lot of loot. Yes, you will not only be getting fishes while fishing, you will also be getting all of these loot over here. As you can see, I just have a lot of fishes over here that I can trade with the villagers to get. You will also get some amazing enchantment books and a lot of saddles, of course, and a lot of name tags as well. You're just going to be getting a lot of loot using this fish farm. So I would recommend you to build this very simple fish farm. Doesn't even take like 5 minutes to build this. You can definitely build this and keep it in your survival world. Guess what, guys, this will also give you a lot of XP as well, and this is a AFK automatic fish farm. So you guys can go ahead and find the tutorial on the top right corner of this video or in the description of this video as well. So there you go, guys, those were all of the methods that you could use to get emeralds. Make sure to go ahead and follow all of the tutorials that I mentioned in this video. All the tutorials are in the description as well, so make sure to build those farms and you could get unlimited emeralds just like that. Thank you so much for watching this video. If this video was helpful, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel. And also, you can comment down below if you want any other tutorials on Minecraft. Thank you so much for watching once again, and I'll see you on my next Minecraft video.